Did you ever think about controlling your home's lights with your TV remote? Or having your room make you feel like you are inside the movie while it's playing? In this episode, we'll show you how we synced our smart home lights with our TV's action, setting everything to come alive and turning movie nights into a cinematic experience. After 9 p.m., our lights mirror every on-screen move. If we pause for a break, the lights shift to a cinema mood, gently lighting the path to the kitchen. Perfect for grabbing a glass of wine without stepping on our daughter's toys. Resuming the movie dims the kitchen light, and again, the living room lights begin to mirror the TV screen, pulling us back into the story. Our setup isn't just about smart technology, it's about creating a responsive environment that adjusts to our family's needs. Turning off the TV doesn't just darken the living room. The hall lights lead the way, staying on for about 5 minutes, giving us enough time for any last-minute tasks before bed. To bring this to life, you'll need an Apple TV 4K, Philips Hue bulbs or strip lights, a Philips sync box, and a Philips Hue Bridge. With the right setup, every night is a premiere at our personal home cinema. Now let's turn your living room into an amazing cinematic experience. If you have seen our first video, then by now you know how to install Home Assistant. If not, you can find the link in the description, pause this video, get some popcorn, and I'll see you later. Step by step on how to integrate the Philips Hue Bridge and Sync Box on Home Assistant. First, you need to set up your Philips Hue lights in the Hue phone app. To help you with that, I'll leave a link in the description so you can follow the Philips Hue instructions. Then, navigate to Settings, Devices and Integrations, and select Add Integration. Search for Philips Hue and enter the IP address of your Hue Bridge. To find the IP address, open the Hue app on your phone, go to Settings, then My Hue System, and press the I button. Copy the IP address. Next, paste it into Home Assistant and press Submit. You'll need to manually press the button on your Hue Bridge, then hit Submit again. Now, assign a location for each light and press Finish. If you click on the Philips integration and hover over your devices, you should find them all listed here. To install the Philips Sync Box on Home Assistant, you first need to install Terminal and SSH and HACS, Home Assistant Community Store. The Terminal and SSH add-on allows access to your Home Assistant operating system's terminal over SSH. HACS, a third-party add-on for Home Assistant, offers a user-friendly interface to discover, install, and manage custom elements not included in the official Home Assistant repository. So, head over to Settings, Add-ons, Add-on Store, and search for Terminal and SSH. Click on it and install it. Enable Watchdog, Show in Sidebar, and press Start. Now select Terminal from the left menu, copy the snippet from the description of this video, and paste it here to install HACS on your Home Assistant. Once finished, restart your Nook. Know this, HACS will only appear in the list after you clear your browser's cache, so don't skip this step. After Home Assistant restarts, go to Settings, Devices and Integrations, click on Add Integration and search for HACS. Click on it, accept the terms, and hit Submit. To proceed, you'll need a GitHub account. If you don't have one, create one now. If you do, log into your account and copy-paste the code shown in your Home Assistant. Hit Continue and authorize HACS. Your device should now be connected. You should now see the HACS add-on on the left menu. Click on it and use the search bar to find the sync box. Click on it again and in the lower right corner, click Download. After this, restart your Home Assistant. Then, go back to Settings, Devices and Integrations, click Add Integration, search for the sync box, and install it. To find the IP address and the identifier, open the Hue app on your phone, navigate to Sync, tap the three dots at the top, select Network Info. Here you can find the IP address. To get the identifier number, go back, tap Device Info, and copy it. Paste both into Home Assistant. Now, if you return to Settings, Devices and Integrations, you'll see the Sync Box integration listed. Click on Configure, then Next. Now you'll need to press the Sync Box button for 3 seconds until a green light shows up. Back in Home Assistant, select your device's location and hit Finish. Now, if you navigate to Sync Box integrations, you can see that many entities have been added to your Home Assistant. Congratulations, you're ready to start all the configurations and automations on your Home Assistant. First, we'll set up the scenes. This first scene served as the standard lighting ambience for our living room, triggered whenever the Apple TV wasn't playing movies or TV shows. So whenever I am not watching TV, this is how my lights will be. I went to Settings, navigated to Automations and Scenes, and selected Scenes to add a new one. I gave it a name, selected an icon, and specified the area. In the Entities section, searching for my lights that were synchronized with the Philips Hue integration brought them up. I included every light from my room, then adjusted the color and the brightness for each by clicking on their icons, concluding with a tap on Save. Then, for the lights off, just duplicate these scenes and open each of the lights and set them to off. Moving on to the first automation. This automation stops the sync box when movies or TV shows are paused. Proceed to Settings, then to Automations and Scenes to create a new automation. For the trigger, use the Entity State option and select Apple TV. In the To field, choose Paused. Next, insert a condition that this automation should only be active between 9 p.m. and 2 a.m. daily. For the action, opt for Switch, aiming at the sync box light to turn it off. Following this, add a 1 second delay, then an action to activate the scene previously set up, which is the ambience light with first setup. Thus, pausing results in reverting to the standard lightning scene. Having saved that, we will then establish an automation for when the Apple TV is idle. The principal adjustment here is that in the To field, we'll select Idle. Remember to label this automation accordingly to Idle. Upon saving, let's create another automation, this time for when it begins playing. The notable difference is in the To field, where we'll opt for Playing, and in the Actions, we'll simply activate the sync box, choosing Switch, and including the entity path for the sync box light sync. We'll add two more automations to ensure the light sync activates only between 9 p.m. and 2 a.m. This prevents the sync box lights from turning on if we're watching a movie during the day. In the first automation, we'll use a time trigger to activate the light sync at 9 p.m. and include a condition to enable the light sync only within the time frame of 9 p.m. to 2 a.m. For the action, we've chosen the switch to turn on the sync box light sync. For the second automation, we'll set a time trigger to deactivate the light sync at 2 a.m. and establish a condition that ensures the light sync remains off from 2 a.m. until 9 p.m. In the action, we selected the switch to turn off the sync box light sync entity. The final automation is to turn off the living room lights and turn the hall lights on for 5 minutes when the TV is turned off. To do this, create a new automation. Select your TV entity set up from on to off. In the conditions, confirm the time is after 10:45 p.m. and before 2 a.m. In the actions, call service to activate a scene, which in this case is sleep, to turn off all the lights in the living room. Then add one more action, which is to turn on the light in the hallway. Then a 5-minute delay, followed by another action to turn off the hall lights. With these automations, our lights mirror the scenes in the movie we're watching, and when it's time for a break or to go to bed, it reacts accordingly, almost as if bringing us back to reality. The time conditions that we used for this example are what best fit our home life. Feel free to use the ones that work best for you. And this is the end of our episode for today. Thanks for watching. Bye.